You know, all of us would like to manage for trophy bucks, but we have to be realistic about what's possible given the resource, the land resource, the financial resource, and how many people you have to satisfy. Mm-hmm. It's hard to manage for trophy bucks when you've got a big club and everybody wants a chicken in every pot, you know. You have to be realistic. So you have to determine what is realistic given my land base, my financial resources, and also the number of people that I got to put a deer in front of. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, trophy buck management is not practical for everybody, but it begins with the land base. If you have 200 acres, you realistically can't manage for trophy bucks. Mm-hmm. You have to manage for quality bucks. And so it all comes back to the land base. And we all have experience managing. I know up there where you are, Mally's from Maryland. And Maryland has some pretty good sized tracts of land, but realistically, you don't find 5,000 and 10,000 acre tracts or 3,000 acre tracts.
Oh, you're absolutely right, David. We just don't have that. Not contiguous yeah. by one yeah. owner or two
yeah.
owners.
Yeah.
We're broken down into smaller tracts. So we have to be realistic with our approach to management. And a lot of times we just stick to the QDM principles,
yeah.
the quality
yeah.
deer management principles. Yeah. And we try to focus on the three and a half year old class,
yeah.
4.5 year old. Anything beyond that's a bonus. And we get some bonuses.
You do.
Being realistic. And you better have some good neighbors if you're going to go beyond that. And that's something.
Or even at 3.5, you still got to have good neighbors.
That's right.
Small tracks.
That's
yeah.
right.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're with the QDM principles.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Now, I said a while ago 5,000 acres. The fact is, under the intensive food plot program, which will tend to hold those deer closer to home, keep them from traveling too much, you can have a dadgum effective program on less than 5,000 acres.
Mm-hmm.
1,000 acres you can work magic with, really, and
yep.
especially if you have good neighbors. But you can do some significant trophy management on 1,000 acres, don't you think, Blake?
Oh, yeah. I mean, some of our plantations, you know, down in South Georgia, you know, we've got properties like that, and we get those bucks up to, you know, 5.5, 6.5 years
yep.
old, and we got nutrition
yep.
there, and we have some, you know, some trophy class bucks.
On 1,000 acres.
Yeah, on 1,000 acres,
yeah.
or even less.
Or less,
yeah.
or less. Again, if you got good neighbors, you can do it on less.
That's right.
Yeah. You've seen that in the places you hunt, Duncan.
Yeah, and you know, you hit an interesting point before. We, back in the 80s, we put together a so-called trophy club in Georgia. We assembled 5,000 acres. But
with a co-op?
Basically, we just had memberships, but we had leased a bunch of land. We were able to control one contiguous
uh-huh.
block of land
mm-hmm.
that was about 5,000 acres. And we had, I think, 22 hunters in our club. We had some very stringent rules. We had rules where everybody had to shoot two does. We
yeah.
were having some overpopulation problems. And what we found was, you know, everybody wanted the monster, and everybody shot the first buck they saw.
Yeah, uh-huh. yeah.
So the thing kind of fizzled. I mean, we had these grandiose plans, but nobody could hold up. And something pretty interesting, this area, we had six-point genetics. We
uh-huh.
had a lot of 6x6
yeah.
bucks. One of the guys shot a yearling 6x6.
What a tragedy.
You know, and they came up with every excuse in the book, and yet, you know, they couldn't control themselves when they saw an antlered buck out there
yeah.
in the woods.
You know, if it was a kid, that's okay.
Unfortunately,
it wasn't. Yeah, that's a shame. But, you know, you're touching on something else, and that's the politics of trophy buck management. Mickey, you run into this all the time. Trophy buck management requires extreme discipline in your harvest strategy.
Extreme discipline.
Extreme discipline. This is a great buck. This is a 4-year-old 160. He's bigger than this guy has ever seen in his life, but he's 4.5. He will be bigger at 5.5 or 6.5. And you have to sit there and say, do not shoot that deer. And man, that is hard when that guy's never killed a 160.
You've got to have the discipline.
You've got to have the discipline.
And you may never again.
And I think it's hard to get to there without first shooting a 160 of any age.
It is.
And then once you've done that, then it's easier to pass up a 4-year-old 160.
But you know what my experience is on trophy buck management is you have to have an authority that has absolute authority on the property.
Right.
That's the reason that clubs on trophy buck management oftentimes don't
exactly.
work. They don't
yep.
work. Where if you own the ranch, like I own my ranch, I say we don't shoot that deer. I mean, I am the authority on the ranch. But where if it's a club and you know, he knows he can get away
with it.
Mm-hmm. They're going to shoot that deer if he's never killed
yeah,
that deer.
That's
he
right.
is. So most of the time on trophy buck management programs that are successful, there's an absolute authority standing over it. You see it on your clubs that you
uh-huh.
manage. And he lays down the rules, hear the rules, live what? Extreme discipline. And it is hard. And we see that all the time on trophy bug programs. I mean, guys begging you, let me shoot that deer. No, you can't shoot that deer. You can't. And there's only a limited number of trophies that can be produced on any piece of property.
Yeah, yeah.
You said the other day, you told me earlier today, that how many 170s, what's the percentage of 170s on the best part of South Texas? Uh-huh. What's the percentage?
About 2.5% of antlered bucks in any given year will grow score above 170. About
Can you believe
percent.
That? 2.5%. Ooh, that's a rare, that's almost 1 in 50, 1 in 40. Mm-hmm. 1 in 40 antlered bucks will ever be a 170. In the best country, in one of the best places in the mm-hmm. world, hey guys, 170, they're rare anywhere. I don't care where you are.
No, they are. Yeah. And I think I read, isn't this true in South, in all of Texas, the average, we think of Texas as the giant bucks, the land of big bucks, but isn't it true that I think the average size is 130 inches on bucks taken in Texas?
4.5. For South Texas, the average growth Boone and Crockett score of a fully mature buck that's 5.5 and older is 130 inches. That's the average. Really? Half of the mature bucks score less than that.
That's amazing.
Trophy buck management is different from QDMA or quality buck management, and it's mostly because of the age of the buck and the intensity of the management. It's not for everybody. QDMA works everywhere. Trophy buck management only works on large land tracts where extreme discipline can be exercised and the guy has the resources to get the job done. Yep. But I tell you what, either one of them are produced good deer, and it is fun in the process of growing these better bucks.
Sure. That's right.